šta sam, nisam mogla ništa raditi, šta ću, ležala sam, on me je silovan jer nije bilo načina nekoga da se ja odbranim, ipak nisam mogla da shvatim šta mi se dešava. Kako da ne, ja sam plakala, majko moja, šta doživi, šta se ovo dešava.
Oružani sukob, smrt, razaranje, pokoravanje. Kroz cijelu istoriju ratovi su uvijek ostavljali teške posljedice po civilno stanovništvo, naročito žene i djecu. Iako uglavnom nisu bile aktivno uključene u sukob, žene su morale šutke podnositi gnusna djela tipična za rat, poput silovanja, mučenja i seksualnog porobljavanja.
Sexual violence goes with war, as if it were to accompany war all the time, cannot be separated from war. And I think at times that's used to excuse its presence, to say, well, it's like the poor will always be with you. Sexual violence will always be there at war. On the other hand, we talk about sexual violence, particularly rape, being used as a weapon of war, which to a certain extent shows that it's just not something that accompanies war. It's part of the destructive acts of war.
1907. godine Međunarodna pravna zajednica konačno je uvidjela da se žene u oružanim sukobima moraju zaštititi. Na drugoj mirovnoj konferenciji održanoj u Hagu usvojene su Haške konvencije. U članu 46. ovih konvencija stoji odredba da se porodična čast i prava moraju poštovati. Ovaj plemeniti, ali nedovoljan pokušaj jednostavno nije bio dovoljan da spriječi masovna silovanja u Prvom i Drugom svjetskom ratu. Nakon Drugog svjetskog rata, Međunarodna zajednica je još jednom pokušala da se obračuna sa ozbiljnim ratnim zločinima, osnivajući dva multinacionalna suda u Nürnbergu i u Tokiju. Neke od velikih nepravdi su na tim sudovima ispravljene, ali optužbe za seksualno nasilje jedva da su bile pomenute.
That has happened throughout time that women have been the victims of war through rape. But it has not been recognized. In Nuremberg, it was just blinked at.
Ženevske konvencije, koje su usvojene 1949. godine, sadrže konkretne odredbe kojima je silovanje zabranjeno. Član 27 glasi: žene će biti posebno zaštićene od svakog napada na njihovu čast, a naročito od silovanja, prinuđivanja na prostituciju i od bilo kakvog napada na njihov moral. Iako je ovom odredbom silovanje kvalifikovano kao pitanje časti, a ne kao nasilni zločin, njegovo uključivanje u konvencije ipak je predstavljalo značajan korak.
Placing sexual violence within the context of serious violations of humanitarian law really tells you that sexual violence is a crime during war.
Više od 190 država je do danas ratifikovalo ove konvencije, ali zločini seksualnog nasilja su ipak i dalje nezaobilazni pratioci oružanih sukoba širom svijeta. Kada je početkom 90. godina 20. vijeka rat zahvatio bivšu Jugoslaviju, izvještaji iz regiona su ukazali na zastrašujuće priče o sistematskom seksualnom zlostavljanju civila. Te priče su bile toliko rasprostranjene da je Međunarodna zajednica bila primorana da preduzme akciju. Ujedinjene nacije su 1992. godine dale mandat komisiji eksperata da na licu mjesta istraži i dokumentuje navode o seksualnom nasilju. Izvještaj komisije je bio nedvosmislen. Pojedine strane u sukobu vršile su seksualne napade i silovanja, tako sistematično da su oni vrlo vjerovatno bili dio sračunate politike.
The extent to which women were raped was so great, it's because it was being done with impunity, because the soldiers or the authorities knew that no action would be taken against the rapists and that the women's voices would never be heard by anybody.
Izvještaji koji su kružili svijetom izazvali su burne proteste i pozive da se nasilje nad civilima zaustavi. Mnogi su se zalagali da svjetski lideri odmah preduzmu akciju povodom ovog gorućeg pitanja. Jedna od njih bila je i sutkinja Florence Mumba.
At that time the UN Commission on the Status of Women was sitting in New York and it was actually during one of the sessions that the commission decided that they should draft a resolution to be passed on to the Security Council, creating a new crime, a new war crime of rape.
25. maja 1993. godine Savjet bezbjednosti jednoglasno je usvojio rezoluciju 827, kojom je osnovan Međunarodni krivični sud za bivšu Jugoslaviju.
The serious violations of international humanitarian law, which have been taking place in the territory of the former Yugoslavia, have outraged the conscience of humanity.
Убийства, насилие, этническая чистка должны быть незамедлительно прекращены, а виновные, какому бы лагерю они ни принадлежали, должны понести заслуженное наказание.
The lesson that we are all accountable to international law may have finally taken hold in our collective memory. This will be no victor's tribunal. The only victor that will prevail in this endeavor is the truth.
Rad na uspostavljanju ove historijske institucije počeo je odmah. Izabrane su sudije iz različitih dijelova svijeta i usvojene pravilnik o postupku i dokazima. Jedno od pravila je već tada osmišljeno kako bi zaštitilo integritet žrtava seksualnog nasilja, tako što je ograničilo korištenje određenih dokaza u svrhu odbrane. Neće se tražiti dodatno potkrepljivanje svjedočenja žrtve. Pristanak se ne može upotrijebiti kao odbrana ako je žrtva bila izložena prisili, a ranije seksualno ponašanje žrtve se ne prihvata kao dokaz u postupku.
I think that the rules provided an atmosphere for the receipt of evidence that is absent in national systems. The rules we considered really contained the highest international standards as they relate to that issue.
Dokazni materijal prikupljen tokom istraga u regionu dostavljen je novoformiranom tužilaštvu.
When we first arrived, the office was still in the throes of being set up. The deputy prosecutor had, in essence, been here by himself for sort of 2 to 3 months, trying to set the office up, trying to get across the magnitude of the crimes. And one area of the Commission of Experts report was sexual violence that he believed had to be investigated.
What happened on the 22nd of August, 1994?
Yeah. First of all, I think when our investigators from the Office of the Prosecutor understood that this was just part of their investigative mandate. Look at the killings, look at the lootings, look at the buildings being burned, look at the sexual violence that occurred.
Krivično gonjenje za zločine seksualnog nasilja nije uvijek bilo bez poteškoća. Ponekad su bili potrebni podsjetnici kako bi se obezbijedila puna primjena mandata tribunala.
A policy which has commonly become to be described as ethnic cleansing was executed in Prijedor. In this connection, it's extremely important to remind that rape has been listed for the first time in the history of the humanitarian law as a crime. So it is very important that the indictments you are considering to issue clearly describe all the different elements of the ethnic cleansing policy. There will be no justice unless women are part of that justice.
So yeah, from that point of view, it wasn't like your normal investigation where you just go out with the information at hand and then you just start your interview and you go through. These are very, very special investigations and they have to be handled with diplomacy, with sensitivity, with aplomb.
Istrage su otkrile složenost prirode zločina seksualnog nasilja koji, između ostalog, uključuju seksualno porobljavanje, mučenje i seksualno sakaćenje.
As we look at sexual violence in war today, we know that it's even much more complicated. It's an issue that's used against men, not infrequently. Men are sexually assaulted because what a better way to demoralize, you know, the brigade that charged the hill than to capture those men and then publicly have them commit fellatio upon each other. It's a weapon. It's because it goes to the very psyche of the person, it goes to a physical sense of the person, it goes to a social sense of the person. It's a very adequate manner in which the person somehow feels that they've experienced a death and yet are condemned to continue to live.
Prvo suđenje pred tribunalom počelo je 26. aprila 1995. godine. Duško Tadić, lokalni političar bosanskih Srba, optužen je za zločine počinjene u logorima u okolini Prijedora.
How do you plead to the indictment, guilty or not guilty?
Nisam kriv I nisam učestvovao ni u jednom od djela koja mi se stavljaju na teret iz optužnice.
And I understand then you're pleading not guilty to each of the charges. Is that correct?
Da.
Thank you.
Predmet Tadić otvorio je put drugim postupcima na više načina. Ne samo da je to prvo suđenje za ratne zločine pred Međunarodnim sudom od Drugog svjetskog rata, nego je također I prvi proces koji je uključivao optužbe za nasilje u obliku seksualnog sakaćenja.
The Tadić case presented really the first case of sexual violence, and it involved not sexual violence against a woman, but sexual violence against a man. And in that case, we were called upon to decide whether or not the accused was guilty of having participated in a horrific act.
Gdje je morao sagnuti se među noge njegove. Naređeno mu je da grize. Spolni organ. Kada sam drugi put pogledao tih trenutaka je jauk kriska urlici. Kada sam drugi put pogledao G, ustao je sa punim ustima, ne mogu znati šta je, bio je sav krvav.
Nakon 79 dana izvođenja dokaza, pretresno vijeće je zaključilo da je Tadić, koji je bio prisutan tokom samog čina, kriv za pomaganje I podržavanje ovog krivičnog djela. Zbog tog I drugih zločina koje je počinio, pretresno vijeće ga je osudilo na 20 godina zatvora.
The chamber found that on 10 separate occasions you beat, stabbed and kicked 19 Muslim men in Kozarac. The Priador barracks, and the Ormazka and Karakterm camps, and you aided and abetted in the beating of one Muslim prisoner and the sexual mutilation of another at the Ormazka camp.
Prva prepreka izricanju osuđujućih presuda počiniocima zločina seksualnog nasilja tako je prevaziđena. Ubrzo su uslijedili I drugi predmeti koji su proširili postojeće pravno poimanje termina seksualno nasilje.
Gender crime could go toward forms of sexual mutilation, and we've already put forward evidence of that, and we received convictions at the Yugoslav Tribunal for mutilation of genitalia. There's evidence of mutilation of other parts of the body. Gender crimes could go to forced nudity, male and female being forced to remain in a state of nudity within a public sphere because they are members of the other side of a conflict. Where gender crime could just go to threatening your physical integrity or forcing you to watch someone else who is being sexually assaulted and sexually violated.
Vojnik okrenuo se Čavić tome mladiću I rekao mu je: Skidaj se. Go. Nek svi vide. Dječak je plakao. Počeo da ga udara I da trga sa njega košulju koju je imao. Strgo je košulju, onda mu je ovim riječima rekao, što ja nikada u svom životu nisam čuo, sad ću te natjerati da siluješ svoju mrtvu majku. Poslije ti riječi, ljudi koji su bili uza zid škole, pokušali su da napuste školu, da napuste zid, da bježe unutra. Ali drugi vojnik je tako oštro reagovao I rekao je, sjedi I gledajte, koji se bude mrdao, bit će ubijen. Mi smo morali da gledamo. Odjednom sam čuo pucanj I pogledao sam kako je dječak pao pored svoje majke.
Sljedeći predmet bavio se zatočeničkim objektom za bosanske Srbe na obalama rijeke Neretve u blizini sela Čelebići. U tom zloglasnom logoru često su vršeni zločini seksualnog nasilja. Tri muškarca, dva Bošnjaka I jedan bosanski Hrvat proglašeni su odgovornima za ove zločine. Zamjeni komandanta logora Hazim Delić optužen je da je više puta silovao dvije zatočenice.
Onda me je povalio na leđa i skinuo komplet onda odjeću dojni dio pantalona i sve znameni što je bilo i čizme te gumene. I onda me je počeo silovati i pa sam zadržala gornji dio na sebi jaknu i neki poluver što sam imala još ne znam.
Who was it who raped you?
Ovaj u štakama što je bio čovjek. Do tada još nisam znala ko je.
Okay.
Ali poslije sam saznala, već ubrzo smo saznali ko je i šta je. Ali nažalost, zgazio mi je ponos. Više ne mogu nikad sebi da dođem, da budem žena kao što sam bila.
Seksualno nasilje u tom logoru nije se ispoljavalo samo u formi silovanja.
Do you remember any other incident, any other mistreatment of other prisoners?
Sjećam se još, bila su dvojica braće, Đorđić i Vaso i Vesel. I mislim, tu, bio je tu i tada i gospodin Delić. Tad su oni natjerali su da se šamaraju tuku jedan drugoga. I onda je Zenga natjerao braću da jedan drugome s oproštenjem polni organ. Mislim, to je žalosno i ponižavajuće. To sam vidio, mislim, od tatiranja i izlostavljanja. Mislim što to čovjek normalan nijukom slučaju ne bi mogao da uradi. Mislim, to je stvarno grozno šta se radilo. Mislim, to su bili ljudi nedužni i bez ikakvog razloga tako su zostavljali.
Mr. Dagović, do not feel uncomfortable. Let's say exactly what they were forced to do.
Oni su morali jedan drugome sa izvinjenjem da puše polne organe. Na očigled svi u nas u angar koji smo bili.
Esad Landžo je osuđen za to nečovječno postupanje. Kao komandant logora Zdravko Mucić je također osuđen za ovo i druga krivična djela koje su počinili njegovi podređeni.
This is the first elucidation of the concept of command responsibility by an international judicial body since the case is decided in the wake of the Second World War.
Pretresno vijeće je naglasilo da je Delić silovao kako bi svoje žrtve kaznio, te da se njegovi zločini stoga mogu definisati i kao mučenje.
A calculated cruelty in the torture and mistreatment of many others. You raped two defenseless women on several occasions, seeking to exert your power over them and instill absolute fear in them. The trial chamber considers the rape of any person to be a despicable act, which strikes at the very core of human dignity.
Veoma važna potvrda da silovanje može biti i vid mučenja. Ovaj pravni presedan Međunarodnog suda sada se mogao koristiti i kao sudska praksa u predmetima koji su uslijedili. Dvije godine nakon početka prvog procesa, ovaj tribunal postao je prvi na kojem je vođeno suđenje isključivo po optužbama za seksualno nasilje. Lokalni komandant Vojske bosanskih Hrvata u dolini rijeke Lašve, Anto Furundžija, optužen je za mučenje i povrede ličnog dostojanstva, uključujući silovanje. Tužiloštvo je tvrdilo da je saslušavao jednu muslimanku dok ju je njegov podređeni tukao, silovao i seksualno zlostavljao.
At that point, this man Sisko demanded that witness A undress. She did so to a point of complete nudity and then said that this man began to stroke her naked body with a knife and threatened to insert it into her vagina if she did not tell the truth. And then, after that, commenced raping her by both vaginal and oral penetration. During this, Your Honours, the accused is alleged to have persisted with his interrogation questions. He did not stop questioning her whilst this was happening.
Iako Furundžija nije lično izvršio ovaj čin, pretresno vijeće je zaključilo da za njega jeste odgovoran jer nije zaustavio zločin koji se odvijao u njegovom prisustvu. Ta presuda je dodatno učvrstila definiciju seksualnog nasilja kao nasilnog zločina.
The trial chamber finds it is indisputable that rape and other serious sexual assaults in situations of armed conflict entail criminal liability of the perpetrators. In this context, the trial chamber upholds the recent finding by trial chamber 2 of the ICTY in prosecutor versus the Lalich and others that in certain circumstances, rape may amount to torture under international law.
Pretresno vijeće je dodalo da silovanje može predstavljati i tešku povredu ženevskih konvencija, kršenje zakona ili običaja ratovanja ili čin genocida ukoliko se zadovolje potrebni uslovi. Tom odlukom pretresnog vijeća također su potvrđeni zaključci do kojih je malo prije toga došao Međunarodni krivični sud za Ruandu. Ovaj sud osnovan je u Arushiju u Tanzaniji s ciljem da procesuira zločine počinjene tokom genocida 1994. godine u Ruandi. Sud ima sličan mandat kao tribunal, a imaju i zajedničko žalbeno vijeće. Na suđenju lokalnom političaru Jean-Paulu Akayesu svjedoci su počeli da govore o višestrukim silovanjima. Iako prvobitna optužnica nije sadržavala optužbe za silovanje, pretresnom vijeću je postalo i jasno da je izvršeno sistematsko seksualno nasilje koje se ne može ignorisati.
I was with my daughter who had been raped.
When was she raped?
Ils l'ont violée.
They raped her when they had come to kill my father.
How many men did rape your daughter?
Trois hommes.
Three men.
Was this question ever put to you by the investigators of the tribunal?
Non, ils ne m'ont pas.
No, they did not ask me this question.
How old was your daughter?
Elle était âgée de 6.
She was 6 years old.
Sutkinja Pile opisuje utjecaj koji je to svjedočenje imalo na pretresno vijeće.
What went through my mind is this mother speaking about a 6-year-old being raped, and we asked her if she knew who did it, she named them. And immediately what struck me and also the other two judges is, why hasn't this been investigated? Because we are here to dispense justice, justice to victims. So all serious crimes should be investigated. We don't want to hear that there's lack of resources or they don't have women investigators. So frankly, that is the first thing that went through my mind. But I felt that as a judge, we couldn't influence the way cases are investigated. But in our courtroom, we control our courtroom and we can draw out that kind of evidence.
Optužnica je naknadno dopunjena i suđenje Akayesu je bilo prvo u istoriji međunarodnog prava na kojem je neka osoba osuđena za upotrebu silovanja kao oruđa genocida.
It was the ICTR that produced a groundbreaking decision with respect to sexual violence against women. It is the ICTR that held that rape can constitute a crime of genocide. That's terribly significant because we know that rape is a tool of war. It's not an isolated act or several isolated acts. It's used as a tool of war. And in this instance, it was used as a tool of genocide. And that has significantly advanced the jurisprudence of this whole area of the law.
Uspjesi tribunala u prvih 6 godina krivičnog gonjenja zločina seksualnog nasilja stvorili su dobru poziciju za suočavanje sa izazovima koji su se pred njim nalazili. 2000. godine trojica bosanskih Srba našli su se na optuženičkoj klupi kako bi odgovarali isključivo za djela seksualnog nasilja. Dragoljub Kunarac, Radomir Kovač i Zoran Vuković bili su optuženi za zločine počinjene tokom ranih godina rata u istočno-bosanskom gradu Foči. Užasne priče preživjelih učinile su taj grad sinonimom za korištenje silovanja kao oruđa rata.
The trial chamber will hear that women and children, some as I said earlier, as young as 12 years old in Foča, were detained and raped vaginally, anally and orally, subjected to gang rapes, forced to dance nude with weapons pointed at them, and even enslaved.
Stotine žena su bile zatočene na različitim lokacijama u gradu gdje su ih vojnici, rezervisti, pripadnici paravojnih jedinica, a ponekad čak i lokalni civili seksualno zlostavljali. Optužbe su uključivale silovanje, mučenje i po prvi put u istoriji seksualno porobljavanje kao zločin protiv čovječnosti. Jedna od brojnih žrtava, koja je u to vrijeme imala samo 15 godina, bila je zarobljena i optuženi su je 9 mjeseci držali kao seksualnu robinju. Na kraju su je prodali za 500 njemačkih maraka.
Are you able to count how many times you were raped in Karaman's house?
Odbrana je pokušala dokazati da su djevojke dobrovoljno sudjelovale u opisanim događajima, a Kunarac je svjedočio u svoju korist i ponudio sljedeće objašnjenje.
Though it was not against your will, actually, you were not raped by the witness, were you?
Nije primijenila nikakvu silu na pitanje časne sudinice. Da li me ta osoba zavela? Da li to tumačim kao zavođenje? Ja sam i tada rekao da mogu da tvrdim da nije silovanje, da me nije silovano na bilo kakav način. Ali ona je sigurno, tvrdim, 10, 15 ili 20 minuta mene i ljubila i mazila i učinila sve da bi me kao muškarca nadražila.
Uprkos tom pokušaju, pretresno vijeće je zaključilo da svjedokinja DB nije svojevoljno pristala na seksualni odnos sa Kunarcem. Bila je u zatočeništvu i plašila se za svoj život.
Consent is not a defense under certain circumstances, at least that was the final and current version of the rules. And that is if a person is subjected to duress or fear, or if, as we later provided, if they fear that members of their family will be subjected to some sort of coercion or threats. So that it's just not foreseeable that consent could be a defense when a woman is in such a coercive and life-threatening situation in a war.
Jedan za drugim, svjedoci su govorili o patnjama koje su preživjeli i sve je ukazivalo na sistematsko i široko rasprostranjeno seksualno nasilje, korišteno za širenje terora.
Women would be raped by so many soldiers over several days or months, in some cases even years, as was the case in Kunaras.
What the evidence shows are Muslim women and girls, mothers and daughters together, robbed of their last vestiges of human dignity. Women and girls treated like chattel, pieces of property at the arbitrary disposal of the Serb occupation forces, and more specifically, at the beck and call of the three accused.
Izricanje kazne Kunarcu za porobljavanje zasnovano na dokazima o seksualnom nasilju jedan je od najznačajnijih aspekata ove presude. Po prvi put je seksualno porobljavanje priznato kao zločin protiv čovječnosti. Time je prevaziđena još jedna prepreka na putu ostvarivanja pravde za žrtve.
You not only mistreated women and girls yourself, but you also organized their transfer to other places, where, as you were fully aware, they would be raped and abused by other soldiers. This behavior calls for a severe penalty commensurate with the gravity of your crimes. The trial chamber therefore sentences you, Dragojev Kunaras, to a single sentence of 28 years imprisonment.
Piramidalni pristup tužilaštva i istraživanju zločina seksualnog nasilja i optuživanju osumnjičenih počeo je da donosi rezultate. Tužilaštvo je sada moglo da koristi prikupljene dokaze i sudsku praksu razvijenu u okončanim suđenjima da poveže zločine seksualnog nasilja sa vojnim i političkim vođama.
You'll never stop all crimes, will you? No. But if you can make leaders think twice or three times before they systematically organize these kind of crimes or fail to take action to punish these kind of crimes, then you are beginning to address impunity.
Biljana Plašić, jedna od pet članova ratnog predsjedništva bosanskih Srba, optužena je za rukovođenje kampanjom progona koju su sproveli njeni podređeni. Jedina žena protiv koje je tribunal ikada podigao optužnicu za ratne zločine, 2002. godine prihvatila je odgovornost i priznala krivicu za zločin progona koji je uključivao i seksualno nasilje.
Sada sam se uvjerila i prihvatam da su više hiljada nevinih ljudi bili žrtve organizovanog i sistematičnog djelovanja, da su ukrolone muslimani Hrvati sa područja koje su Srbi smatrali svojim. U to vrijeme ja sam olako ubijedila samu sebe da je ovo pitanje opstanka i samoodbrane. U stvari više od toga, naše rukovodstvo, čiji sam bila neophodan dio, vodilo je poduhvat koji je za žrtve imao nebrojne nevine ljude.
What the tribunal has done, I believe, first just by listing rape as a crime against humanity, but secondly by prosecuting it and by developing the jurisprudence of sexual violence, is that the leaders of these conflicts are now put on notice that the rules have changed.
Utvrđivanje činjenica o stravičnim zločinima seksualnog nasilja u bivšoj Jugoslaviji bilo je moguće jedino zahvaljujući odlučnosti onih koji su došli da ispričaju svoje priče.
Ja sam se ovdje zaklela istinu da govorim pred ovim sudom i pred ovim narodom. I želila sam jednom da kažem istinu i da se zna istina šta se je radilo. Da li se je moralo desiti nama tako nešto što nam se je desilo?
These women primarily are enormously courageous to come and testify under very difficult conditions, because you think about it, rape is the most personal of crimes, and you sit in the courtroom across from the person who's raped you.
We had quite a number of witnesses who gave evidence in open session, especially in the Kunaras case. And they came, they were very willing, and even during the time that they were giving evidence, that they were determined to tell the truth because they wanted justice to take its course. And they also said, because the trial chamber gave them a free platform to tell the world what had happened to them.
What I think people hadn't imagined, And how could they, given the newness of this endeavor, was to the incredible and overwhelming logistical nightmare, whirlwind, of trying to bring people from dozens of different countries, one of them a war-torn post-ex-Yugoslavia, internationally in and out of The Hague, to be able to testify. So it was always imagined that witnesses would be traumatized, that it would be difficult, and that they should have support.
Pionirski napori službe za žrtve i svjedoke postali su značajan dio nasljeđa Međunarodnog suda.
So witnesses would say to me, I've been asked to testify, I'm ready to testify, but I can't because I've got three children under five. The childcare policy was born. I want to testify, I'm ready to testify, but I can't, I look after my elderly disabled father. The dependent persons policy was born. I want to come, but I can't, I earn 5 Deutschmarks a day, it's all our family's got to live on. The attendance allowance policy was born. So all our support programs, or the things that make it possible for witnesses to testify without further suffering or harm, grew out of listening to witnesses to understand what it was that they needed.
As a result of all the rapes that you suffered during these many months, did you continue to suffer?
Mislim da za čitav moj život neke misli ili neka bol koju sam ja osjećala i koju još uvijek osjećam nikad neće nestati.
Uspjesi tribunala za bivšu Jugoslaviju i Ruandu imali su velikog odjeka u sistemu međunarodne krivične pravde. Dokazano je da vladavina prava funkcioniše i da predstavlja ključni instrument u borbi protiv seksualnog nasilja širom svijeta.
international humanitarian law, for the most part, was on paper and not applied before this tribunal was established. Today you can't say that. This tribunal has a long record. The ICTR has a long record. The ICC, although in its infancy, is beginning to establish itself. There's Sierra Leone. There's the extraordinary chambers in Cambodia that's been established. There are international judges sitting in various parts of the world.
Na osnovu velikog doprinosa koji je tribunal dao razvoju sudske prakse na ovom polju, ovi novi sudovi sada se mogu kompetentno baviti zločinima seksualnog nasilja. Dokazano je da su statut i pravilnik tribunala legitimni i funkcionalni pravni instrumenti.
Humanity normally moves forward, so we can't subtract from what we have got at this stage. So future tribunals, if any, and even the ICC itself may improve upon its statute by being more specific with these offenses.
Tribunal je prokrčio put ka ostvarenju pravde za žrtve seksualnog nasilja diljem svijeta. Sudovi u bivšoj Jugoslaviji i Ruandi sada igraju značajnu ulogu u globalnim naporima da se okonča nekažnjivost osoba odgovornih za ove zločine počinjene protiv naše čovječnosti.
I think you probably have seen an enormous impact in the long term. That impact is not complete yet, but you're beginning to see it. For example, I talked about the 11 BIS cases, the indicted cases we transferred down. Now, in the prosecutor's office, we're handing over dossiers, materials, investigative materials, and so forth for local prosecutors, not just in the state court in Bosnia, but throughout the region to bring prosecutions.
You may ask yourself, you know, has this really had an impact? The reality of it is the crimes related to gender-based violence are now very explicitly spelled out in the ICC statute. In the long run, I think it will serve as a deterrent. And if nothing else, I think punishing perpetrators is giving back to the victims some of their dignity that has been taken away. If it's only that.
I think the international community has a responsibility first and foremost to persuade the leadership, the political leadership of each member state to bring it to the attention of their nations or their people or their military forces as to what is going on and what is up to date in terms of cases like rape and other war crimes in the way we are trying to protect the women.
You will not find a body of law that's, I would say, one-eighth as lengthy about sexual violence under international criminal law than you have with just compiling maybe five or six of our cases together. There's been more jurisprudence out of our tribunal in 5 years than in the past 500 years from international criminal courts. And what they've contributed overall is basically placing the sexual violence in its legal context.
The jurisprudence of ICTY and ICTR, I believe, to a certain extent, will deter the future commission of these horrific crimes of sexual violence, because the would-be perpetrators are put on notice that the rules have changed, that if they commit these acts, they do so at their peril, and that they will at some time appear in the dock of an international tribunal.
Thank you.